was my first love, and it will be my last. Music of the future and music of the past. To live without my music would be impossible to do. In this world of trouble, my music pulls me
High Sheriff, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Theatre Brycheiniog in this 130th year since the historic battle for Hoogstrift in South Africa. Tonight, Paris Army Cadet Force Band is hosting this 12th Hoogstrift concert, and they're supported tonight by Army Cadet Force cadets and adults from 10 different ACFs across Great Britain. I'd like to take this opportunity whilst I'm here to thank them all for joining together this evening, to come together to entertain us in the way they have done here in Brecon for the last 11 years. It is a truly monumental feat to bring together these musicians to play for us. And I thank them, and also the hidden volunteers behind the stage, and in locations such as Court of Gothlin, where the essential administration is carried out to allow this concert for you to happen tonight. So thank you to you all. But particularly, there is an individual who has been associated with this concert since its inception and has continued to inspire and use his imagination to develop this. Tonight, there are 170 musicians performing for you, 100 of which are cadets. And it is he that brings them together, nurtures them, and brings them to the standard that you've already heard and will hear a lot more this evening. And therefore, it's my pleasure to introduce the musical director and our compere for this evening from the Welsh Guards Band, Sergeant Adrian Beckett.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and as the Commandant has said, welcome to the 12th Hoogstrift concert. From Scotland we have guests, from England we have guests, from Ireland we also have guests. Welcome to the nation of the Six Nations champions. And in advance of the next month, welcome to the double grand slam. We've got lots to show you tonight. The opening, of course, a little fanfare tattoo on stage, stolen from a tattoo in Switzerland only last year. And followed, of course, by John Miles' music, a piece we used here about 6 or 7 years ago. Sung by Howell Dowsell, who had... All right. I found him, I'm his agent. Who sang that very piece in the finale of the Malta Military Tattoo with 500 musicians behind him in October last year, and has just accepted and been chosen after a very, very long selection process for a part in the Welsh National Opera's production of Sweeney Todd in July this year. So book your tickets. Congratulations to them. Late. Half past 7, if you're in the army, you've got to turn up on time. This year, of course, is the 130th anniversary of that great battle and that wonderful film. Not 130th anniversary, the film, of course. And to celebrate that, we are going to play the theme tune from that. We've never done that here before, and it's an intriguing piece of music, and of course ends in a famous Welsh march and victory along with the rugby last week. Now, I'm not one to harp on about the rugby. I will later on, no doubt, go on a little bit more about it. But to continue straight away with that wonderful theme tune written by John Barry, to conduct our musical director, great friend as well, just back from Wanted Down Under, if you watch that programme. Luckily, he decided to show the British flag and he's come home. Nothing to do with his age and not being able to get in on a visa. So please welcome back the over 40, unable to go to Australia. Ivan, here he is. enjoy a little bit of Michael Caine. Don't blow the doors off. It's Zulu.
State for War has today received the following dispatch from Lord Chelmsford, Commander-in-Chief of Her Majesty's forces in Natal Colony, South Africa. I regret to report a very disastrous engagement which took place on the morning of the 22nd January between the armies of the Zulu King, Cetshwayo, and our own Number 3 Column, consisting of five companies of the 1st Battalion, 24th Regiment of Foot, and one company of the 2nd Battalion, a total of nearly 1,500 men, officers, and other ranks. The Zulus, in overwhelming numbers, launched a highly disciplined attack on the slopes of the mountain of Isandlwana, and in spite of gallant resistance, the column was completely annihilated.
Thank you.
left up here, it has to be said. Any more, I'm going to have to buy a ticket. And their musical director, Major Dennis Burton. And underneath all of that uniform, not Major Burton's uniform, but in the front row, we have Adam Davis, a former cadet from Powys Army Cadet Force, who's now in the Territorial Army. Keris Davis. I mean, is everyone called Davis in Wales? Keris Davis as well. And behind that, James Lewis on bass drum, who looks as if he's just about to be strangled. Now, continuing with the Six Nations theme, as I like to do, we've decided to have a little bit of a sing-along with the band that plays on the pitch before all the matches that Wales win. Am I milking it? You're all right over there. I think it needs feeding.
Not coming.
So, singing, or even you're singing, they're playing hymns and arias, and a little bit of Tom Jones, Delilah. Please, sing along to the Regimental Band of the Royal Welsh. Surprises you can take in one night, is there? I'm not going to say anything more about the rugby. That'll be a surprise. Well, we're going to continue because I think we've already been twice as long as last year's first half. We've only done the first half of the first half's first half. Are you keeping up? Okay. But just to let you know that the gentleman in the tuba section, who seconded, who was stood up at that point when they marched off to their regiment, the Marchmen of Harlech, it wasn't because he needed the loo or because his seat is too small to take his body. It was because he is part of that regiment too. So that is the reason why, because someone was backstage saying, is he okay? The answer is no. He's English. He's not, actually, but I thought I'd add that. Our next piece is written by a gentleman called Robert Hazo. Now, he is quite a well-known musician in America, and he went back to his old school one day and was chatting to the music department and to their head teacher in his school in New York, and the head teacher said, will you write us a piece of music in your honour for the school that you were once in? And he did, and it is called Solus Anae. It means yesterday's child, and yesterday's joy it also means as well. Thank you. It's got a double barrel name. But it's quite a poignant piece, because by the time he finished writing it, and on the day that they performed it, and the high school band performed it, he discovered 2 minutes before he went on stage and conducted that his mother had passed away. So this is a very special piece to him, and it is a person that I met when I was on a tour in America a few years ago. So it is also it was quite nice to meet him and understand why and where this piece came from. It has got a lot of Celtic twists to it, a lot of little Celtic drumming, and although being American, an American piece, it feels a little bit like Wales. No joke about the rugby there. Doing well, told you, it was a promise. So to conduct Solus Anae, please welcome back Ivor, I'm not going to Australia, Evans.
Thank you.
So there we are. Sorry, it's quite nice. There was a little bit of Irish feel to it as well, a little bit of Scottish feel, and a little bit of Welsh feel in there as well. And the little bit at the back that were coming second, that was an English feel. So we're going to continue now. Now, what has happened this afternoon to celebrate the 130th anniversary? I'm sure most of you were in Brecon wondering what was going on, unless, surprisingly enough, you read the Brecon and Radnor. And you knew the 1879 group, in fact that doesn't work out properly, but whoever they were marching through the town of Brecon, accompanied by the Cambridgeshire Corps of Drums. Now, they come down from Cambridgeshire, obviously, to spend the weekend with us in our new accommodation in Crickhowell. No longer are we sleeping on the floor, no longer are we going outside to the toilet, and no longer are we using the outside tap to fill the urns in the morning. We've got an inside tap, we've got beds with mattresses and a little light above it, but we've got no plates to eat anything off. But we solved that problem. But everything is, so there we were, and then we were practicing, and they came down to Brecon to play. Did anyone see them go through Brecon this afternoon? Yeah. Both of you, well done, thank you. thank you for that. Oh, we've got spotlights this year. I don't know if you've noticed, we've paid an extra couple of pounds. They're on work experience. Care in the community, I like to call it. But what I promised I wouldn't do was move too quickly, because I don't think they'd be able to keep up. So every now and again, if you find me moving around, that'll be, well done. All right, clever. So, when they arrived back here with their marching party, I said to them, what are you doing this evening? They said, well, we're going back to Crickhowell, look for some plates, and to use our new taps and beds. They're from Cambridge, these fellas. They're Welsh Cambridge. And I said, well, why don't some of you come on the stage here, because, quite frankly, there's a bit of a space here now, and do a little bit of drumming for us, a little bit of bugling, and a little bit of fife playing. And they said, why not? Good accent in Cambridge, isn't it? See, the Welsh are taking over everything, aren't they? Amazing. And they said, yes, okay, we will. So, we threw them on about an hour ago, before you arrived, and we're going to throw them on again and see what happens. I think you'd rather enjoy them. So please welcome, from Cambridgeshire, their first visit to Wales, the Cambridgeshire Army Cadet Force.
Andy Clark.
They did all right, didn't they? You're the best, yeah. You haven't paid for that seat, should I? So, following on with our drum theme, because I'm well aware that it's now snowing outside. It did one year, didn't it? It did? Ah, you've given it away, you've been before. How many people have been to all 12? I can't see a thing. At the back, well done. So have I. Next year's free. 20th of February next year. Put it in your diaries. No rugby on, we will have won it by then. To continue our drum thing, last year I met a young man from Gwent Army Cadet Force. And he's all right, isn't he? I thought he's just fallen off the stool. Just went the same way as I did. And of course, and his name is Billy Smith. And he lives down in Gwent. Now, most of you will know by now, I think by the papers, that you'll realise that Powys and Gwent Army Cadet Force is amalgamating. So technically, he's now one of mine. It's a winner. And I said to him, I'd like you to do a solo at Rourke's Drift concert next year. And he said, okay then. He's Welsh too. But what do you give a drummer to do? I thought to myself, because it isn't, you know, you can bang a cymbal, it's not that interesting, to be fair. A triangle, a little bit more boring. And there's those long gold things that they go up and down with. Can you do that? I quite like those, though. But to be fair, 4 minutes of that is going to become a bit wearing. So we discovered a piece called Sing, Sing, Sing. And it features the drums on our Billy. Now, Billy says in the programme that he's a likeable young lad. He wrote that. That worries me. So, playing Sing, 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 up on the stage. I hope you can see him on the screen, on our new camera. Yes, he's lost a bit of weight. He also looks like a lion. Here is William. Billy! Go for it. Now.
So,
you might be wondering why I have a mask, hat and horse on. To be fair, I couldn't get a horse. Well, I've got to be honest, this is hurting a bit. Now, the reason I'm doing this, and it's also hurting my eyes, is because the next piece, I can't see anything. Oh, there you are. The next piece is called Who's That Masked Man? Or in Welsh, Who's That Masked Man? And it contains all the pieces from our superheroes and heroes in our lives who have been wearing masks. Now, I know we'd like Colonel Van Rees to wear a mask. But he hasn't got one big enough to cover those airy bits. So, the Lone Ranger, the Incredibles, Spider-Man, Batman, the Phantom of the Opera, the list goes on. So does the piece. Hopefully we'll be out of here by Tuesday. Look, who's that masked man? Please welcome back. He's not in Australia, he's here tonight. It's Arthur Evans. final piece in the first half. Yes, we've got to the interval. Many thought we never would. Felt like it. Now, we're going to have a 20-minute interval after this. Don't forget that a raffle ticket's on sale. I'll be in the bar. Gin and tonic, please. Also, there's other little bits and pieces on sale, and all the proceeds go to the Army Cadet Force and buy next year's music, quite frankly. So please spend generously, and it's ice and lime. Now, this nice next piece is a favourite amongst those behind me, and it's entitled Abba Gold, or in Welsh. And it starts with one of my favourite pieces, and my boss's favourite piece too, Dancing Queen. And it goes on into Mamma Mia, and a whole load of things. I won't go on, because I can't find them on the page. And to conduct that is a great friend of ours. He's the bandmaster of the Berkshire Army Cadet Force Band, and has been here for many years, and a great supporter of the Rorke Strip concert. Please welcome Mr. Tony Bevin. Now, as in all the Rorke Strip concerts, this is a participation support, okay? There's no coming second. There's clapping, there's singing to do, and there's dancing. If you want to, please feel free to get up in the aisles. There's a bit of a floor here. Get up, find your partner, bring your wife up to dance. Bring someone else's wife up to dance, it doesn't matter. Put your legs up in the air and dance away. Have a great time. We'll see you in 20 minutes, but not until we've danced to ABBA. come back. Who was sat there? Where have they gone? We have an announcement. In fact, I've got a couple of announcements. I was approached by a few people in the interval. The Commandant of the Royal County of Berkshire is in the audience. It has royal before its name. A little bit like the Royal Court Tavern I've just been drinking in. But not as grand. So I apologise to the Royal County of Berkshire. Thank you. Thank you. Guess who's not coming next year? Also, Baker Green has told me that he is 111 in 5 days' time. And he's in the balcony somewhere. How'd you get up there? No, he's not here, he's ill. However, catch up. Eric Abel is actually here, and he's not ill, and he's 80 today. So happy birthday, Eric, wherever you're ready. And that is return for all your practical jokes that your friends have, you've played on your friends. So I don't actually know if Eric is 80. He's mostly 21. But no, he is 80, so happy birthday, Eric. Right, we're going to continue now, and some music that no doubt Eric and David Green, if he wasn't ill and here, knew. And that is a selection put together. It's 85 minutes long. We've condensed it down to a little bit quicker, and it's 83 minutes long. And it's entitled, From Down Under. To be fair, Glenn Miller didn't go to Australia either. So we're in good company. Please sit back and sing along, tap along. You recognise all the tunes, some great tunes of the great era of the big band time. It is Miller. Thank you. a little bit of Glenn Miller. Do you know, we must get you in earlier. Could you hear us, Alan? That's good. We could hear you. Right, we'll continue straight away. Now, of course, in the last 12 months, one of our great services, the Royal Air Force, has celebrated a great anniversary, their 90th anniversary, I think it was last April, since they since they were formed. And I know very well that there are lots of Royal Air Force people in the audience this evening. So, for you, all right, there's one Royal Air Force person in the audience who we're going to throw a fish to after the seal impression. So, welcome. This is the Army. I look forward to your Dan Busters concert. Obviously, it'll have to be in a 4-star hotel, and it'll have to be during the week because I don't work weekends. If you like the Royal Air Force, we'll get you there. It's all fine. So it is. It's still Saturday, isn't it? So, in honour of that great celebration, to conduct the Dan Busters March from, of course, the great film and the great battle. We've had a film evening this evening. Is the bandmaster of the Shropshire Army Cadet Force. Please welcome Mr. Ian Brady, who's here.
Thank you.
course. Now, we're going to continue straight away with a young man who's going to play a tuba solo. I don't think we've had one of these at the Royal Strip concert before. And he's a musician, Lee Davis, from Glamorgan Army Cadet Force. He's been playing for about 8 years. He used to play the euphonium, and then we went on to bass. I met this young man last year in a place called Nestcliffe, a little camp on a music school, and I heard, when I found out where he was from, and he's from the Swansea area, I thought, lovely boy, you'll do nicely. I said, what are you doing on February 21st? He said, I don't know. He's got a very high voice, so I said, well, I can tell you what you're doing. So, and I've just spoken to him outside, and just before I come on, have you ever done a solo before? I have, in front of my mum and dad. So this, mums and dads, is just a little bit bigger for him. Please make Lee very welcome for his first solo at the Royal Strip concert. Please welcome Lee to play bass in the ballroom. Here at the Royal Strip, travel down from Cumbria Army Cadet Force. Please welcome Jeff Blencar.
Thank you.
Wales were playing Australia, and I went up to see the Argyll and Southern Highlanders battalion. They were holding a Christmas concert, so they invited me up. They were holding a summer concert at Christmas, doesn't matter. So up I went, and during the rehearsal I had to whip out quickly to the local to check on the rugby. So I walked into the Hogmanay bar, or whatever it's called, and I said, in my best Scottish, would you be showing the rugby? And at which point, the stereo went off. You could hear the barman stopped serving beer and dropped the glass. And he said, which game? I said, well, the Welsh game, of course. At which point, on went the stereo, on went the glass. And they said, of course, we thought you were coming to watch England, New Zealand. So, and I went back to this concert. And on this concert went on. It went for about 3 weeks. It's a bit like this one. During the second half, on came this little fella, and with a set of bagpipes that were bigger than him. And I heard him play. So I said to him, in my best Scottish, what are you doing on the 21st stage? Because I want you to come down to play at the Rorkestrith concert in Brecon. And he said, well, I'll have to ask my mum, who was stood next to him, because he's only 14 and a half. And it's taken 14 and a half hours to get here. With stops, he says, with stops. So, please welcome his first concert in the Rorkestrith here in Brecon, and also his first solo in front of such a warm, welcoming audience. Because it has to be said, he's a bit worried, because he's never been to Wales before, and he's heard lots of stories. And they're not all good. Some of them are. Not from you, man. But Sean Reardon has come all the way down, 14 and a half hours, 14 and a half years old, only been playing for just under 2 years. Please give him a very warm welcome as he comes to entertain you with the bagpipes.
Thank you.
tell you in the next piece you do that no one will clap along or do anything until the last note. Only the last note, when everyone's finished, what they'll all do is jump on their feet and shout, "We love you, Ryan," and start screaming and shouting. It happens all the time to me. To conduct a joint item with the band, I'm young. It is Ryan, isn't it? Sean. Why am I calling you Ryan? Oh, it's Raffle. Doesn't matter. Raffle's next. To conduct. It's good, isn't it? It's professional. 12 years and I'm still. Doesn't matter. I'm the best for the fiver they pay me. What about Ken Dodd? You'll be here at midnight. Right, to conduct the joint item, which is entitled, it's a little ditty, a slow and a quick piece. Paddy's Green Shamrock Shores on the little quick jig of the Pumpkin's Fancy. The bandmaster of the Argyll and Sutherland, a really long title, Royal Regiment of Scotland Army Cadet Force. It's a bit longer than that, but I've forgotten the middle bit. Their bandmaster, Bob Cowan. He took a little bit longer to come down because of the weight issue. Bob's first time at the Rorschach concert, of course, with Sean Ryan, his new double-barreled name. Don't forget the ending. Our duet.
Thank you.
last year when I was 26.
You're a hard crowd, you are. I could go and do the concert somewhere else.
With my other friend. Well, now, if you remember the programme on ITV, I think another series just finished, is called The X Factor. And,
why do you laugh at that?
Because it's rubbish. No, The X Factor, and they find some wonderful talents that usually stick around for a couple of weeks. However, one thing they did this year for a charity entitled Help the Heroes, which helps people who are injured in the military, in our conflicts around the world, they recorded a piece of music for the charity, the great charity Help the Heroes, entitled Hero. It was originally a Mariah Carey number, and it was a great hit many years ago, and then it became a great hit for the X Factor contestants. So, in honour of what we're going to do and ask you to do when you retire this evening from the theatre, is to give only, if it was a penny, it would go to help a young person, a young man or a woman, who comes back from these conflicts, injured or disabled in any way, it would go to help them. And regardless of your political beliefs and what you think they should or shouldn't be doing, or where they should and shouldn't be, that when they have been sent there, then we should support them. And especially so when they come home. I'd also like to let you know that I'm running for a member of European Parliament. No, I do believe that, and that's how it should be. So we're going to play that song this evening, and to sing it, this is going to be another first, it's a duet. Beth Jones and Howell Dowsell from Howard's Army Cadet Force, and to dance ballet to Hero, Mariah Carey's Hero, it will be Rebecca Young from Derbyshire Army Cadet Force. So, a bit of ballet, a bit of culture for you, eh? Better than Jim Davidson being here, isn't it? I was going to do a Jim Davidson joke then, but I won't in front of the children. Okay? Everyone's waving at me. Why are you waving at me?
Yeah, she's there.
Oh, well, don't blame me. Right, anyway. To dance and to sing, Hero, please welcome our trio and the band.
Side when we
here's the exciting part.
It's the raffle.
And I love this bit, as you can imagine. Wasn't that good? Don't forget, a little penny would do. 2 pence, 5 pence would make all the difference to these people. So thank you very much. Right, here we go with the raffle. If we put the house lights up, we'll be able to see our raffle tickets. Ooh, don't put them up too high. Well, you are there. So what I'll do is go down to this young lady on the end here. If you would put your hand in my bearskin. That sounded a bit rude, didn't it? Yes, I do apologise. Oh, hello, I haven't seen you for years. Are you all right? Pretty well. And the first prize, which is a hot plate. A hot plate. Yes, hope yours works. And it is on the yellow ticket, and they are 126 to 130. 126 to 130. These will be available for collection at the door as you leave. And then the next, I will go to this young lady here. How did the rugby go in Scotland, Jim? That good. That's turned into a riot, isn't it? Right, we'll get through. The next thing is a picnic hamper. Just what you need in February when it's pouring down the rain. Oh, we think about these. And it's on the white ticket and 236 to 240. Okay? And the next one, this young lady in the front. Honestly, goodness. Last time. All right. Not for me getting up. This one is for the 1.5 kilograms of Thornton chocolates. Ooh. That's a lot, isn't it? On the pink, 241 to 245. Right, this is for the hair straighteners. Do you think that someone's messing around? Do you think? I can't see the end of the stage, so if this goes wrong, you're wrong. Would you like to put your hand in my bear skin? I've done it twice and it went bad a long time. There we are. And for the hair straighteners, let's hope you don't win. Eh? On the same here, leaving. On the pink ticket, 201 to 205. I do hope you have a fine head of hair. Now we're talking for the litre of Bacardi. With litre of Bacardi, I'll go here. I'll lean over to this young lady here. Good evening.
Oh, that's okay.
Thank you. And this is on the white ticket for the litre of Bacardi, 171 to 175. The bottle of port. Better. I can't get over the hair straighteners. The bottle of port. For you. You've got to come up with something different every time. Maybe for a laugh. Just because your solo went wrong. And for the bottle of port is the white ticket, 521 to 525. And for the very last prize of an Easter egg. Let's hope you don't win the Thornton's chocolates as well. Okay, for the very last prize, this young lady here. You're gonna laugh, isn't it? You try teaching. But that was an adult, wasn't it? Yeah, mate. Bring it out, Steve. Those buttons will fill after the for the... oh, my goodness, what are we doing? It's for the Easter egg, and it is on the pink ticket, 196 to 200. If you have any questions, that has been written down in the wings by my trusty stage crew. Once you put the scotch down. Dear God, I want to see this one. So, a few years ago, and I appreciate everything you've done in buying everything, because the money does come back, it isn't given away, it isn't thrown in the bin, it comes back to the cadet force that you've come to support this evening, and buys music, and that so these people behind me can learn something new every year. So we appreciate what you do very much indeed. However, the next piece is a sister piece to something we did a couple of years ago, which was called Dancing Around the Nursery, which was a load of nursery rhymes all put together into a little jaunty tune. Now this one is a sister piece called Marching Around the Nursery. You can tell what style it is, because the clue is in the title. It's a load of nursery rhymes put to a march. It's not difficult. It wouldn't be if that went off. Especially there. went to see the England-Wales game last year, and I bought a couple of tickets, rather drunk, on the Friday night in a pub in Twickenham. Didn't know where these tickets were in the stand, but I exchanged money, didn't even know they were real. So I took my trusty stage manager, who's Scottish, and I said, we're off to see the rugby. Here's your ticket. We weren't sitting together. There's my ticket. So off he went. We didn't know where they were. And he disappeared up into the top stand, beautiful view of the great, victorious Welsh team. I was the only person in the disabled enclosure without a wheelchair. And that is actually a true story. I felt a bit bad, so I started limping. But that is a true story, and I was right on the edge of the game. So that is a true story, but a little bit of fun there. So, goodness me, to conduct marching around the nursery. How did I get to rugby about the nursery this morning? Our illustrious bandmaster, Pete Ward, who has just started the new Derbyshire Cadet Force Band, which Rebecca Young is a member, and their legend is their first time to Wales, I think, and it's then their first concert in a mass band situation with all the others. And here's Pete, a very nervous-looking Pete, doing a quick impression of Baldwin and his slug balancing act. We're not marching around the nursery. You recognise all the little tunes and some great little drumming pieces. So sit back and clap along and recognise the nursery rhymes of marching around the nursery. Well, sadly, we've come to the end. Oh, you know you want to go home. Of course, we have to say a big thank you to lots of people. Thank you. There we are, that's that done. I think specifically to our wonderful selection of conductors from who have travelled from far and wide, but especially to some certain people. To Ryan, the piper, to Sean, the wonderful Sean Reardon, to Howell and Beth, our singers, to Rebecca, our dancer, and of course, to Lee and Billy, our tuba and percussionist. Gentlemen and ladies, stand up and take your bow. Of course, the wonderful staff at this wonderful theatre. The backstage crew are absolutely incredible. I also have a huge team of people. I sound like Shirley Bassey, but I do have a huge team of people who helped me with this concert, with the lighting and the sound and the staging, putting up and getting everyone here. So to those people, to Chris and to Gary up on the spotlights, and to our only deaf sound man in the world, to Simon, and to Dan and James and Kate on lights, and to Caroline and Kath and my little brother Ian, who's bigger than me, to all the crew. Thank you very much for making this evening happen. However, of course, we have to thank everyone in the band behind me for turning up to Wales. And it's been a wonderful few days in Crickhowell. It's been sunny and we've been outside. It's been wonderful. So give a great big round of applause to the wonderful Rorschach Band of 2009. The band that joined us in the first half, a little bit of a surprise for you all, I hope. We can't afford them every year, and so hopefully we'll see them again and we'll work with them again soon. And of course, the very last thank you to the wonderful Corps of Drums from Cambridge, who have worked so hard this afternoon in Brecon Town Centre, and to you two for annoying me all the way to the concert. Well done, and to you as well. So thank you to the Cambridgeshire Army Cadet Corps of Drums. Two of their drummers in our finale piece as well, so we haven't just seen the last of them. However, the last piece is also the last time that a certain gentleman, Colonel Timothy Van Rees, will be in charge of Cadet Force Music as he's retiring. Now, I know that comes as a bit of a shock to you all, not least us, because we thought he would just go on forever. So our finale piece is dedicated to him. It's entitled Lord of the Dance. And the reason it's entitled, because he is the Lord, and he certainly led me a merry dance for the last 17 years. So, at the risk of allowing him to come anywhere near this stage, I'm going to get on with the finale, because we'll be here until a week next Tuesday, but he doesn't half go on. I tried to get the great Emperor Vanus Rees's picture from the Brecon and Radnor, but they seem to have lost it conveniently, though sorry, the threat of being sued by a great local solicitor. And I hope you have enjoyed sitting in the dark, because I've read the Brecon and Radnor news and I know that you have your lights off at night when you're driving around. It saves a bit of money though, doesn't it? Shame about all the car crashes, but don't worry about that. So, to finish this wonderful concert this year, we're going to play the great selection of the Lord of the Dance, Michael Flatley's great creation. Sit back and enjoy. If you want to dance, be careful, but watch. They're expensive replacements nowadays, girls, when you're getting those legs up there, okay? But if you want to, feel free, come and dance. The Lord of the Dance. Thank you. Sorry. Enjoy that then?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit of dancing fun. However, I'll let me introduce you to our two drummers, Duncan Elliott here, who's a corporal from Cambridge, and our newly 17-year-old birthday boy, Jamie Martin. Happy birthday. During the anthem, so I'm quite looking forward to this. They're available to buy on the way out if you want those little teddy bears. Only a couple of pounds, I don't know. All the money goes to this drinking fun. We'll put it together. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed this evening. Wonderful cast and crew here. You've been an absolutely wonderful audience, as you always are. We'll see you on February the 20th next year. God willing, we'll be here. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves. I hope you've enjoyed meeting us, because we've certainly enjoyed meeting you. Good night, God bless. Have a safe journey home. The National.